here in the house of the Lord to lift up and to magnify Hallelujah. Jesus. We come to celebrate Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is the Hallelujah. Center of our world this morning. So I invite you not to be a spectator, but to participate in worship unto the Lord your God. As we come into this house, give him your best offering, the sacrifice of praise. Let your worship cost you this morning. Let the worship of the Lord be a sacrifice unto you. The psalmist David says, we bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord, and we offer unto him the sacrifice of thanksgiving. We offer unto him the sacrifice of praise. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody clap your hands unto the Lord this morning.
Praise the Lord.
And let your worship tell him he's welcome in this place as we Hallelujah. Worship him together. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We celebrate you, Lord. We celebrate you. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The songwriter said, forward still is Jehovah's will. Though the billows dash and spray, with a conquering tread we'll push ahead, and he'll roll the sea away. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Then forward still is Jehovah's will. Though the billows dash and spray, with a conquering tread we will push ahead and roll the sea away. When Israel out of bondage came, a sea before them lay. The Lord reached down his mighty hand and rolled the sea away. Then forward still it's Jehovah's will, though the billows dash and spray, with a concrete tread he will push ahead and roll the sea. Before me was a sea of sin, so great I failed to pray. My heart desired the Savior's rest and rolled the sea away. Then forward still is Jehovah's will, though the billows dash and spray, push ahead and roll the sea away. Oh, then forward still, it's Jehovah's will, though the billows dash and spray, with a concrete tread it will push ahead and roll the sea away. Oh, it is truly wonderful what the Lord has done.
Truly wonderful.
Truly
wonderful.
Oh, it is truly wonderful what the Lord has done. Glory to his name. He pardoned my transgression. He set me by my soul. Confession, since by his blood I'm on. Yes, it is truly wonderful what the Lord has done. Truly wonderful,
truly wonderful,
truly wonderful. Oh, it is truly.
Lord has done. Glory to His name.
I'm not a single. He keeps me in every moment. My trust in His grace. It's true, His grace has shown. Truly wonderful, truly wonderful. It is truly wonderful what the Lord has done. Glory to His. He brings me through affliction. He leaves me not alone. He wins me in temptation. Wonderful what the Lord has done.
Truly wonderful.
Truly
wonderful.
Yes, it is truly wonderful what the Lord has done. Glory to His name. It's truly, 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 truly wonderful what the Lord has done. Truly wonderful. What the Lord has done. Glory to His name. So I would not be denied. I would not be denied. Since Jesus came and made me whole, I would not be denied. I would not be denied. I would not be when pangs of death seize o'er my soul, unto the Lord I cry. Till Jesus came and made me whole, I would not be denied. I would not be denied. I would not be denied. Oh, I would not be denied. Oh, since Jesus came and made me whole, I would not be denied. Oh, Satan said my Lord was gone and would not hurt the Lord. But praise the Lord, the work is done. I stood upon His hand. I would not be denied. And roll the sea away. Warrior, oh.
strength, he will push ahead and roll the sea away.
Then forward still, his Jehovah will, though the billows dash and spray, so with a concrete tread, he will push ahead and roll the sea away. Whatever storm you might be going through this morning, understand that he is the Lord of the storm and he's the Lord over the storm. And your storm is a stepping stone to your next destiny. Hey, Jesus. And he commands us to go forward. Because once you have surrendered your life to Jesus, you are enlisted in the army of the Lord. And so we are warriors in the army of Jesus Christ. We are fighting from a place of victory, and we cannot be denied since Jesus came and make us whole. I would not be denied. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the midst of what we might be facing or going through or coming out of,
hallelujah,
his name will be magnified. Should be magnified in our hearts and in our lives. Oh, glorify your name, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, Jesus, be magnified this morning. Be magnified, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, be magnified. Hey, God, be magnified this morning. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hey, God, be praise. May all the praise be unto you. Be magnified, oh Lord. You are highly exalted, and there is nothing you can do, oh Lord. My eyes are on you. Be magnified, oh Lord. Be magnified.
Be magnified.
Be magnified, oh Lord. You are highly exalted. You are highly exalted. And there is nothing. And there is nothing you can do, oh Lord. Oh Lord. Oh Lord, be magnified. I have made you too small in my eyes. Oh Lord, forgive me, and I have believed in the lie that you were unable to help me. But now, oh Lord, I see my wrong. Heal my heart and show yourself strong. And
I ever lean on the wisdom of man.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord, forgive me, and I have responded to them instead of your wrath and your mercy. But now, oh Lord, I see my wrong.
Oh Jesus,
heal my heart and show yourself strong. And with my eyes and with my song, oh Lord, be magnified. Oh Lord, be magnified.
Be magnified.
Be magnified.
Come on, think it up in this house. Big him up in your heart this morning. Big him up in your worship.
Oh Lord, oh Lord, my eyes are on you. Be magnified,
Jesus.
Oh Lord. Be magnified, oh Lord,
be magnified.
Tell him in your heart,
be magnified,
oh Lord, be magnified.
Jesus, Lamb.
To give up, I'd be a fool, for you are my holy home.
Jesus, you are the Lamb of God.
Shame!
Take it, my-
upon the water, the great unknown, my feet may fail. And there I found you in the mystery, where ocean deep my faith will stand. And I will call upon your name.
Hallelujah.
And keep my eyes above the waves. When ocean rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine. Oh, 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 oh.
Your grace abound,
your grace abound. Waters, your sovereign hand,
hey God,
will be my guide.
Oh, where
my feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you never fail and you won't start now. My soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine. Oh, oh, oh.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters, wherever you would call me.
Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my my Savior.
Spirit leads me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters,
wherever you would call me.
Take me deeper than my feet will ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger
in the presence of my Savior.
He will never leave you, lead you where you feel comfortable. If you're gonna ask him to lead you, then you must prepare to go through trials and testing and fiery trials and flood and storm. If he's going to lead you, don't expect it's going to be comfortable for you. Hey, Jesus. I pray we will sing the song this morning with meaning. God, wherever you lead me, I will follow you. Hey, Jesus. Sometimes it's true difficulties. Sometimes it's true needs. When it seems like nothing is in your cupboard and there is not a cent to rub against the other, he will lead you there. Oh, Jesus. They can be so uncomfortable to the physical man, but as long as you trust him. Hey, Jesus. He's an intentional God. You belong to him. Oh, Jesus. Sometimes it doesn't make sense, but follow his leading.
Lead me where my trust is with without borders. Let me walk upon
no limits. No limits. No limits. If he's gonna lead you, you have to trust him all the way.
Deeper than my feet could ever wander. Woo. My faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
Your grace abound in deepest waters. Your suffering hand will be my God. When faith, faith, and faith surround me, you never fail, and you won't start now. And I will call upon your name, Jesus. Keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, so will rest in your embrace. I am yours. In the midst of it,
keep my I'll trust eyes your God. Above the waves.
Cause one thing he says, the river
oceans rise,
will not so overflow you.
In your embrace, for I am yours. And
you are mine. You are mine. You are mine.
Oh.
Rise.
My soul will rest in your embrace. For I am yours. You are mine. Oh, oh, oh.
Come on, tell him, Lord, wherever you lead me, will follow. I cannot go under because you uphold me with the righteousness of your whole right hand, your end of strength. And all the enemy might be rejoicing, I'm still victorious because you are leading me. You are leading me. You are leading me. I will follow you, Lord, even when it doesn't make sense. Even though I can't see my way through, you are my way, you are my fruit, and you are my life. Hey, Jesus. You lead the way.
I might not see it now, but you save the best for all who trust
you
and obey. There is an answer, no more delay.
There's peace when I say yes.
There is peace when I say yes. I may not see it now, but you say the best for those who trust you and obey. There is an answer, no more delay.
I just say yes.
Done.
to your
my
will.
My soul says yes.
My soul says yes.
Oh yes.
Says yes.
Ooh, yes.
Says yes.
Lord.
Says yes.
Yes, Jesus.
My soul says yes. Says yes.
Hallelujah.
To your will.
Wherever you lead me, God. Wherever you lead me. Wherever you lead me, God. As we are living in this crucial time. And there is wars and rumors of wars. And we tend to be comfortable. But God, like the eagle pull the comfort zone. Because they need to fly. And so the mother eagle stir up the nest. So it become uncomfortable for the eaglets to stay. And that's where you're calling us, God, into a zone, Lord God, that you alone will lead. And if you don't lead, we will perish. For those you love, you've chastened. For our next opposition is a position that you have given unto us to station us into greatness. Oh, Salushka. Sede kamundai sampriosa. Be my way, God. When I can't see the way, oh God, be the door that will open. When I can't see a door, yet you make one. There never were. I surrender to your will and to your ways this morning. I surrender to you, God. I will trust you and obey. When your spirit speaks to me, help me, Holy Spirit, with my whole heart. Help me to agree. Because God, we as human don't readily agree to the testing, oh God, that will come our way. But Lord God, give us the sight to see. Give us discernment, God, that it is you leading in this battle. It is you leading in this trial. It is you leading in this testing. For your word says, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try us. But when we are tried, we shall come forth as pure gold. That's what the master wants for us. Our opposition station us for the position in Jesus Christ to lift us to our higher realms than we have never known before. Beyond the open door, he who opened and no man can close. He who closed doors and no man can open. Esa kutala mandolo bosa. Yeah, Jesus. Yes, do you will? Oh God. Somebody this morning don't feel comfortable where you are. But he says, I am the one. I am in the boat. And the storm cannot overtake you while I am in your boat.
You might say, God, it don't make sense. But can I tell you, don't resist him. Trust him. Don't resist him. Give him praise. Don't resist him. Worship. Worship him. Even when it don't feel comfortable. Even though he moves you from your comfort zone. Worship him. He said, don't be afraid when men rise up against you. I am with you, says the Lord. Hey, Jesus, to deliver you. Your response should be, yes, Lord. Whatever it takes, the moment you choose, I say yes. Jesus, I say yes. I say yes. My soul says yes. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. My soul says yes, God. Even if I have to cry, I say yes, Jesus. I will not go into depression because I will be praising you in the midst of the mess. There will be a message. Ekosandolobos. Who am I talking to this morning? He wants to bring a message out of that mess. When it doesn't make sense, he wants to bring a story out of you that would bring him glory. I need thee. Oh, I need thee. Every hour, I need thee. Oh, bless me now,
my Savior.
I can't do it on my own, God. I need a revelation of Jesus. I need thee. I need
thee. I need thee.
Every hour. Every hour.
I need thee.
Oh, bless me.
Oh, bless. Now, my Savior, I come to thee.
I need thee.
I need thee.
Oh, Sabalisha, I recognize, Lord, that I need you more than anybody else, more than anything else. I need you. I don't need money. I need you. I don't need a job. I need you. Oh, God. I can't live without you. I can't live without money. I can't live without anybody. But I cannot live without you, God. I need you.
I come.
Lord, I come and I confess,
bowing here, I find my rest.
For without you,
I fall apart.
righteousness, oh God, how I need thee.
Where sin run deep, your grace is more. Where grace is found
is where you are.
And where
you are,
Lord, I am free.
Holiness is Christ in me.
Oh, I need thee,
Lord, I need thee. My one defense,
my righteousness,
my righteousness.
Oh God,
oh God, how I need
Lord,
thee.
I need thee.
Lord, I need thee. Oh, I need thee.
My one defense,
my righteousness, oh God,
I need you,
how God. I need you,
my one defense,
my righteousness, oh God, how I need.
Defense, hey, Jesus.
My righteousness, oh God, how I need you.
My one defense,
my one defense.
You are my righteousness.
My righteousness,
oh
God, how I need. Righteousness, oh God, how I need you.
My one defense,
my one defense, my righteousness, oh God, how I need you.
This is the moment of intercession. Whatever your situation that you might be going through, the altar is open. We will pray with you. We will believe with you. If you know somebody that is sick, you can also come and stand proxy for them. We believe. When we pray, he answers. We believe. When we pray, he pay attention. If you desire anything, the word of the Lord says, when you pray, believe that you receive it and you shall have what you say. Things might not make sense to you. And you might need a revelation. Jesus is saying, I am here. I am with you. I am in the midst of you. I am here to deliver. When he revealed to redeem. He don't just reveal for your comfort. But he revealed so that you will be redeemed from your situation. And delivered from your situation. He is in this house this morning.
Defense.
Ela basonto lobosa.
Righteousness.
Recota mandosa. Priende le basa.
How I need.
Eh,
is able to do it. Hey, there is nothing too hard for your God.
Oh God,
nothing too hard for your God to do. Oh Jesus,
Lord, I need you.
Hey God,
oh,
He's able. He's able to do it exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ask.
My one defense
is your defense.
My righteousness.
If He don't defend you, nobody else can. No matter how big they are, no matter how rich they are, if God don't defend you, nobody else can. He's your one defense.
Oh, I need you
against the enemy that seek after your soul to destroy.
I need you.
He's your one defense.
My one,
whether you want to believe it or not,
my
righteousness.
Oh God, how I need you. My sin run deep. Your grace is more.
Ministers, can you go ahead and minister and pray for those at the altar? Oh Jesus. Oh Jesus. Oh Jesus, Jesus.
Lord, I am free. Holiness is Christ in me. Lord, I need you.
Oh,
I need
you.
I need you, my one defense, my righteousness. Oh God, how I need you. Lord, I need you.
Hallelujah. Let's believe God for those at the altar this morning. Oh, we bless you, we bless you, we bless you.
I need you.
We exalt you, King Jesus. Lord, we need you this hour. We need you. God, if ever a time we need you, is now. This very hour. We call on our defender this morning. We call on the righteous one, the Holy One of Israel, the one who can fight all our battles. Mighty God of Daniel. God, we lift you up this morning, God. We depend on you, God. In our own self, we fail. In our own self, God, we will not put our trust in ourselves because we are mere failures. But God, we trust in you this morning, God. Lord, we rely upon you this morning, God. Lord, we depend upon you this morning. Lord God, we come to you, Lord God Almighty. Lord, so our faces are different. So our needs are different. Our burdens are different. Our struggles are different. Our concerns are different. But God, we come unto you, God, who can make the impossible possible this morning. We come to you, oh God, because you are the one who can fix it, God. We come to you, mighty God, because you are the God who, oh God, can turn things around for our good. So, mighty God, we lay our burdens before you. Your words declare to cast all our cares before you, God, because you care for us this morning, God. We lift up every situation before you, every issue, every pain, every hurt, God, in the name of Jesus. Every demonic association, agents, oh God, and influencer, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we ask God.
in our situation, God. Lord God Almighty, intercept the plans of the enemy. Destroy the works of darkness. Pull down every principalities and powers in the mighty name of Jesus in our lives today. Oh God, we cancel every work of darkness, Lord God. We put an end, oh God, to it right now. Every destruction, everything to our demise, God, we call an end to it. We speak life to every dead situation right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We call for life. We call for life in the name of Jesus. Right now, God, we speak to life over everyone that is standing at the altar. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, those who are standing for someone this morning, I pray, mighty God, that you will do a miracle work in their lives, God, because we believe your report this morning in the name of Jesus. Do it again, Lord. Do it again, Lord. Do it again in our lives. Move in our lives today. Have your way, God. Take control in the mighty name of Jesus.
You do.
Let your will be done, God.
You won't grow weary.
We need
you,
your help,
are
God.
Defender.
We lift up our eyes unto the hills.
You come first.
From whence cometh our help? Because our help comes from you.
Wings like
we
eagles.
Are not in the boat, you God.
You are the ever.
You have never lost the battle.
God.
And you will never lose a battle.
God,
Lord, in you we live and breathe and have our being, God.
Glory.
Come true for us this morning, God.
You are
see us true this morning. In Jesus'
you
mighty name.
Those in need.
Jesus' mighty
and
name.
And lift us up on wings. Like eagle, you are the everlasting God. The everlasting God, you do not faint, you won't grow weary. You are defender of the weak, you comfort those in need, and lift us up on wings like eagles. You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God, you do not faint, you won't grow weary. You are defender of the weak, you comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles. You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God, you do not faint, you won't grow weary. You are defender of the weak, you comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like the everlasting God. You are the everlasting God. Oh yes, you do not faint, you won't grow weary. You are defender of the weak, you comfort. You lift us up on wings as eagles. The everlasting God, you are the everlasting, the everlasting God. You do not faint, Lord. You don't grow weary. Oh, you are defender. You comfort those in need. You lift us up. You lift us up. Do that one more time. Come on and stand and declare it. Everlasting, the everlasting God. Everlasting God, you do not faint, you won't grow. You are defender, you defend us, Lord. You comfort those, you lift us up. up.
You lift us up, oh, we.
The everlasting God, one more time.
Ooh. You are the everlasting God.
Yes. The everlasting God.
You do not fail.
You won't grow weary.
You are defender of the weak.
You comfort those in need.
You lift us up on wings as eagles.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the everlasting God. Hallelujah to the King of Kings. Hallelujah to the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah to our Comforter. Hallelujah to our Comforter.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Jesus. Don't you know that when you come and you pray and you ask the Lord to do something for you, you must declare it. You must declare who He is. And that's the reason why you are depending on Him. That's the reason why your trust is in Him, because of who He is. He's the everlasting God. He will not faint. He won't go weary. He will comfort you in the time of your need. He will deliver you in the time of your storm. He will deliver. The deliverer is here this morning. The comforter is here this morning.
You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do not faint. You won't grow weary.
You are defender. You comfort those in need. You lift us up, Lord. On wings
as
the everlasting God. The everlasting God.
Lift us up on these as
eagles. Come on and shout unto the Lord. Shout unto the Lord. Shout unto the Lord.
Hallelujah.
With the voice of triumph, we shout unto you, Lord. We rejoice in your love. We rejoice in your grace. We rejoice in your healing. We rejoice in your comfort. We rejoice in who you are, Lord. Hallelujah. We rejoice in the Lord. We rejoice, we rejoice, we rejoice in you. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Clap your hands once more and take your seat in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. The word of the Lord said that in His presence there is fullness of joy, and at His right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Hallelujah. We just want to thank God for each and every one of you here worshiping with us this morning at Deliverance Worship Center, and those of you who have been tuning online. Hallelujah. He is the everlasting God. He do not faint, and He won't go weary. He won't go weary. He won't get tired of you calling on Him. He won't get tired of you at all. Hallelujah. For He's a God same yesterday, today, and forever. And that's why our confidence and our trust is in the Lord. At this time, I'm going to call on our dear sister Audrey, and she's going to come and make you feel even more welcome.
Bless the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. The Bible says the Lord inhabits the praises of His people. Come on, people of God. Just worship the Lord this morning. Let's worship the Lord this morning. Today, I don't know about you, but I'm happy to be alive. God is good all the time. God is good. Praise God. This morning, we just want to welcome the Holy Spirit who's already here with us. Can you feel His presence? Yes, we just want to welcome Him this morning. And then, of course, we want to welcome our Bishop, John Cohen, and his beautiful wife, Prophetess Cohen. Give them a warm welcome this morning. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. And then, of course, we want to welcome all the leaders in the different departments. Let's make them welcome this morning. Praise God. Praise God. To our YouTube viewers, we just want to welcome you this morning. I am sure that you are enjoying and receiving the Holy Spirit right now as we are here receiving, even though you're not in the presence with us right now, physical presence. I am sure that you are blessed also this morning. Praise God. Praise God. This morning we have with us, we just want to recognize a book club group. We have them with us this morning. Could you please stand so that we could give you a warm welcome? Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Sister Diane. Okay, Sister Diane, Sister Maureen. So I just want to welcome you guys this morning. I hope that you are blessed, indeed blessed this morning. We are happy to have you here. God bless you. Praise God. Are there any first time or second time visitors with us this morning? No? Is there anybody who's celebrating their wedding anniversary this morning or close to this today? No? Okay. Okay. Are there any birthday celebrants with us this morning? Brother Chavez, Abby. Okay, this morning, we just want to wish you a happy, happy birthday. Travis and Trevor, we just want to wish you a happy birthday, Brother Trevor. And of course, I'll be celebrating mine on Wednesday coming. Yes. Yes, so this morning, it is so good to be in the presence of the Lord. And I hope that you will not leave the same that you came this morning. I know I'm not leaving the same that I came this morning. Sit back because the best is yet to come, where we'll receive the word of God. God bless you this morning. Thank you. Praise God.
Amen. And we know as she just mentioned, Brother Travis, today is your birthday, right? So come up, Brother Travis. Yes, and Trevor, his other half, or the twin, who is not here today. For those of you who didn't know that Travis is a twin, yes, he's a twin, and the other part of him is not here today. And so I'm going to ask the congregation to stand, and today's his birthday, and we're going to sing him the happy birthday song. Amen. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Travis and Trevor. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. May the good Lord bless you. Yes.
May the good Lord bless you
all the days of your life.
May the good Lord bless you.
May the good Lord,
may the good Lord,
may the good Lord bless you. Happy birthday, brother.
Happy
we
birthday.
Love you and we appreciate you and the good work you have been doing in the kingdom of God. God bless you. Amen. At this time, the book club is already welcomed, but at this time I'm going to welcome their leader, Sister Diane, and Sister Maury. Okay. Sister Maury, you're going to come and you're going to share with us a little bit more concerning your book club. Amen. It's good to have you guys today.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we've got cause, we've got a reason to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen? Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Thank God I was a guider, because they say be prepared. Bless the Lord. When they put you on the spot, you must have something. But we are grateful to be here. We are the Avid Readers Book Club, and we are a group that we aim is to read, we learn, and we share. At the moment, we are working on our first book project. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. So we are writing a book, and the title is From Trial to Triumph. There's a lot in there. How we overcame, from trial to triumph, how we overcame. There's a lot, we're telling our stories of how God brought us through. And I know each and every one of us in here have a story. And the thing is, your story is not just for you. It's for you to help somebody else. And if they don't know, they can't get that help. And so we have a breast cancer survivor, a story of a breast cancer survivor. We have a story of domestic violence. There are a variety of stories in there. Something that will bless your heart and minister to you. Something that God has for you in that story. Amen? Amen. And if you are interested in writing a book, we will help you. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. We have learned so much over our journey. We get together and we edit one another's story. We ask one another's questions. So this is authentic. This is our book of authenticity. And I'm guaranteed you will be blessed. We are really privileged to be here worshiping with you today. Sister Myrna is a part of the group, a very valued sister. Bless the Lord. And we want to say, before I leave, I'd like to encourage you to hold to God's unchanging hand. It will be worth it after all. If you don't know him, today is your day. Now is your chance. While the blood is flowing warmly in your veins, you have an opportunity to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and serve him and live for him, that on the other end, you'll be rejoicing through eternity. God bless you.
Amen. And I'm also seeing Sister Kayan here, who's part of the book club. We welcome you again. Amen. At this time, I'm going to ask us to stand, please. Everyone. And I just want you to be reminded of our mission. Yes, this is our mission here at DWC Worship Center. And if you find yourself not doing what this mission says that you're doing, you need to start. Amen? Start. Amen. We're going to say it after 2, 1, 2. Our mission is to develop a loving, caring, spirit-filled church, fully equipped to proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God to everyone, everywhere, with hope. We're going to do it one more time because that's how we do it, right? Our mission is to everyone, everywhere, anytime, with hope. Give yourself a hand for doing so. Amen. Amen. Remember, the church is not these four walls or six walls or whatever it's made up of. The church is out there, and it's everyone that is a part of the world or the kingdom. Amen. Amen. And at this time, I'm going to call on Prophetess Cohen. She's going to make the announcements, and she's also gonna let you worship with your giving of the offerings. Amen.
Good morning again, everyone. Protocol already established, and I'm here to give the announcement for this week. Tonight, there will be no service. You are off for tonight. For those who would come out to regular Sunday evening ministry service, there will be no service tonight. However, on Tuesday, we will have our Bible study. On Thursday, we will be having our prayer meeting. And can I see all the ministers immediately after this service this morning? Coming up on the 26th of this month, we are invited to the Mount Carmel Baptist Church. It's their Ladies Month, and they're having a sing-along or Sankey night. And we are invited to bring an item. So ladies of this ministry, please let us endeavor to go and support with our presence and also to participate in their Lady Sankey night. This week, Pastor will be leaving us. He will be going to a conference in Virginia. And so I'm asking that we pray as he travel. He will be traveling on Tuesday. So please keep him in prayer. And even though he's not feeling 100%, but God is faithful. And we expect God to change his story, because that's what he does. He changed our story, and we give him glory in the midst of it. And I think that is the announcement for this week. Coming up is our, and I want you to be sensitive to this date, the 9th of June, which will be our anniversary, church anniversary. We will be 8 years old. So you will hear more about all the activity that will be coming on, leading up to and after. But I just want to sensitize you to the color. Minister Petra will let you know, impart that information to you so you can, as soon as she possibly can, so you can get your things together, what needed for that great celebration. The number 8 represent newness or transformation. And so we are walking in the year of greatness, and we expect greatness because our God is great, and he will never fail in doing what he says he will do for his glory. And so we give honor and glory unto him. It is time to worship the Lord with our tithes and offering. Lord, and it make me feel so good. Me not have to ask again. Thank you so much. Our God is awesome, and he's worthy to be praised. He is the God that's always giving. He never holds back. He said, if you will. So when we hold up to our part of the bargain, he is the one that will give us. The word of the Lord says that we should worship the Lord with our substance. Found in Proverbs 3, verse 9. Worship the Lord with your substance and with the first fruit of your increase. God is not a God of second. Or you give him when you don't have anything else to do, or you can spare a little dollar. Because when he's blessing you, he's not asking nobody opinion how to bless you and when to bless you. So therefore, the word of the Lord says, with the first fruit of your increase, that it may be well with you. And if God says it's going to be well with you, trust me, you can put your pot on fire, even though you with water. If you don't have no water, we make water come in it. And also he will put food in it, provision in it for you to have abundant. Because he's a God of abundant. In Malachi 3, it says, will a man rob God? And their answer returned, yes, you have robbed me in tithes and in offering. Then how are you going to rob God? He owns the cattle on 1,000 hills. He don't need you or need my money for anything. But hear what he says. When you are robbing God, you're robbing him of the opportunity to bless you.
When you hold on to your little 2 cents and your little dollar and your little whatever he tell you to do, and you hold on to it, you're robbing God of the opportunity to bless you. So therefore, he said, bring all the tithes into the storehouse and also the offering, that there may be meat in my house. And he said, after you have done that, prove me. Watch if I would not open the windows of heaven and pour out blessing that you have not room enough to receive it. The other day, I look around and I said, God, I'm in need of nothing. I really don't need anything. And I call that a blessing. I call that abundant blessing. I might desire to have this or desire to have that, but I don't need anything because he supplies all my needs. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And even your little desire, Lord, I would like this. God is able to even bring your own desire to you when you honor him with your substance and with the first fruit of your increase. Hear what the word of the Lord says in 2 Corinthians 9. It says that the God, don't let nobody, first he said, do not let nobody coerce you how much to give or what to give. And then he go back and he said, if you're so stingily, that's how you're going to reap. And if you're so abundantly, that's how you are going to reap. And he said, he love a cheerful giver. Sometimes when you say offering, everybody just, they're just quiet. They're just, but no, he loves a cheerful giver. So if you can give cheerfully, that's how he enjoy blessing you cheerfully. The word of the Lord says, he rejoices over you with singing. Imagine God singing over you. Wow. That is beyond our comprehension. The God who makes us rejoices over us with singing. So as you place, you have already, should have already know how much or what you're going to give. It's not my place to coerce you. It's not my place to tell you how much to give. It's my place, however, to encourage you to give not sparingly, but to give joyfully. And give what the Spirit of the Lord have already placed in your heart to give. Take your seed, take your tithes in your hand. If you notice, I did not say anything about tithes because that belonged to God. Without question, it is a tenth of your earning or whatever you have. A tenth. So that goes without question. Can you stand to your feet with your seed and your tithes in your hand? Our God is able. To make all grace abound. Towards us. Having all that you need. And having all that you desire. He's able to do. Above and beyond. Can you lift your seed to the Lord? Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we give you thanks for all good gifts around us are sent from heaven above. So we thank you, Lord, for all good gifts. As we lift our offering, our tithes to you, our seed to you, some are giving this morning sacrificially, Lord Jesus, because there is a need in their life. And that will not fulfill the need, so therefore it is a seed. And so as we give the seed back to you, I pray this morning, Lord God, for those who are in lack. I speak against the demon of lack. I speak against the spirit of lack. I speak against the spirit of delay. Delay blessing. I speak against stagnation in the name of Jesus. And I rebuke that spirit from the life of God's people. I rebuke the spirit of poverty from the life of God's people in the name of Jesus. So this morning, as we sow our seed, Lord God, I pray that you will remember us, Lord God, like you remember Anna. Oh God, your word says you remember Anna and you place that seed that she desired in her womb. God, I pray that you will remember your people this morning. And you know the needs, Lord. You know the things that we desire. And your word says whatever we desire when we pray, we should believe that we receive it and we shall have it. God, I pray for abundant blessing upon your people this morning in the mighty name of Jesus, that you will reciprocate, oh God, back to them in good measure, pressed down, shaken together and running over. God, cause men to give into their bosom. God, raise up destiny helper, Lord God, for your people this morning. We are trusting in you, Lord. And oh God, we will not be denied because you are our provider. You are the way maker. You are the money, God. So I pray, God Almighty, those who are suffering, God, of luck, financial luck, economical situation that doesn't make sense. God, I pray for a turnaround this morning, God, as they sow their seed. I give you praise. And I thank you, Lord God, for the result. Because we know when we call upon you, Lord, you will not fail to answer. Oh God, and to reciprocate, Lord God, everything we need back to us. We thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. We bless the seed now. We bless these tithes. We bless the offering in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name. At the instruction of the usher, you may bring your seed to the Lord.
Amen. And at this time, I'm going to call on Brother Curtis, who is going to come.
And also, I'm sorry, the building fund we have over here, can you put your seed also in the building fund for the glory of God? Brother Curtis.
Morning, everyone. God gives life and he takes it away. He is the potter and I am the clay. When I view the last sunset and cross all the sea, I know a sunrise will be waiting for me. And oh, what a sunrise it's going to be. Death will lose its sting form, and the brave is victory. The silence will be broken, and the storm clouds rolled away. I hear the saints of angels singing on a homecoming day. God will come for the last goodbye. Tears, a smile, don't fear in your eyes. Death will take ours, and only to sleep in the arms of our Savior, so sweet. And oh, what a sunrise it's going to be. Death will lose it's thankful, and the brave is victory. The silence will be broken, and the storm clouds roll away. I hear the saints of angels singing on a homecoming day.
Amen, amen. I hear the saints of angels singing. What a homecoming day. If you all look so good in here this morning, can you imagine that day? Can you really imagine that homecoming day, what it's going to be? Let's stand and sing, oh, what a sunrise. And oh, what a sunrise. It's going to be.
It's going to be.
Death will lose its sting.
Death will lose its sting.
In the grave.
And the grave is victory.
Oh,
the silence will be broken,
and the storm clouds roll away. I hear the saints of angels singing, what a homecoming day. Come on and rejoice in the Lord your God for that homecoming day.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Remain standing, please. I'm going to ask everyone to remain standing at this time. At this time, our heart is ready for the word, and I pray that our heart will be good ground, and the word of God will not fall on rocky grounds where, you know, it gets squeezed and choked. But we pray that our heart will be the soil for the word this morning. As the sower, our vessel, Bishop John T. Cohen, comes and deliver what the word of God, what the Lord has given him to say to us this morning. I pray that you will just raise your hand towards him while he stands there, and his wife is for him. And we are going to pray that the Lord bless him. So just put your hand there and pray out of the goodness of your heart for him. Ask the Lord to bless him. Ask the Lord to deliver his word with power as it comes through his humble servant this morning, that his mind will be cleared and that he will be led by the Spirit, and that the word of God will be a blessing to your heart, and that it will take root and it will spring forth fruit in its season. Bishop John T. Cohen, the Lord bless you.
Praise Jesus. Amen. 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 You may be seated. I greet everyone, wonderful people of God, and the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Those that are watching online, I greet you. This is indeed a day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. May I suggest to you that that is not a suggestion. That is not a recommendation. That's a command of God. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. So we are commanded to rejoice and be glad. Hallelujah. I want you to continue to pray for me this morning, because there are so many folks that have been knocked over by the flu virus that is going around. And while some have been battling it for weeks and days and stuff like that, you see, I make up my mind. Yeah, it might knock me down for a day or two, but on the third day, I shall arise. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. So my voice might still feel a little bit shaky. One of my goodly members told me yesterday that if they ever see me, when they saw me yesterday, they say if they ever see me come up here so to preach today, they're going to come and take me down. But I don't worry, because we have capable ministers in here. So even though I was still prepared, I turned to my son and said, "Get ready to preach, because I don't know what's going to happen." But I have a word for us today, and I give God thanks for that. Amen. I want to also recognize Minister Keon Roberts, you know, Maids, and all the wonderful people of God, Minister Diane and Kenrick Lewis. Amen, amen. Good friend of ours and all the rest of the book club. Thank you so much for gracing us with your presence this morning. It's indeed a wonderful to have you. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. You know, when the Lord gave me this message, I wasn't sure what, I mean, I didn't know all that was happening. But I don't know how many of you knew that Israel was attacked this morning by Iran. Hundreds of missiles and drones into Israel. And if we should look around, it's indeed the last and closing days. And this should be a wake-up call for those laid back, lazy, unproductive Christians to get their act together, because soon and very soon we shall see the King. My text this morning is taken from 2 Chronicles chapter 7 from verse 12 to 22. And my topic is, the answer is already provided. It doesn't matter what the question is. It doesn't matter what you're experiencing or what you're feeling. The answer is already provided. If we know the scripture well, we are familiar with the text. But the promise in today's scripture, it comes when Solomon was dedicating the temple. They were going through a period of progress. In chapter 8, we'll see that. They were enjoying a time of peace. In chapter 9, it was a period of unparalleled prosperity. Verse 13 to 28 of chapter 9. The temple was the evident that things were going very well with Israel. Yet, we see from today's scripture, at the time of the dedication, that God has a special message. God has always been fair with humanity. It doesn't matter what you see happening around, and it doesn't matter what you have heard and all this kind of stuff. I remember one person, my family said to me when they had this great big earthquake in Haiti, I said, "Where is your God?" He said, "The children in Haiti didn't do anything wrong." See, there are many innocent people that are suffering, that died, that didn't do anything. So where is your God? And I said, my God is right where he has always been. Then he says to me, he said, "That's the problem with you Christians. You always need a crutch." I said, "You're so right about that. You are so right." I said, "If you have never said anything truth in your entire life, what you have just said is truth. Because Christian needs a crutch. Now a crutch is in Jesus Christ. Because without that crutch, you cannot function." I said, "What you see is the evidence of sin. Of sin. But I want to let you know this morning that whatever you see going on, whatever the result of sin, God has provided the answer." You see, in verse 19, God attempted to alert the people of Israel to the temptation that they would face. And in verse 20, he told them the price of yielding to those temptations. And you get to verse 14, he told them in advance what the solution that problem would be. So even though the
the situation has not yet arrived, God had preempted them as to what humanity will do and can do, because he said the heart of man is desperately wicked. All of our tempers doing good end up in failure. And there's a reason why many times we try to do good within our own self, but that's not enough. Because the goodness of man cannot meet, not even meet the minimum requirement of God. It simply means then that our only solution, or the only way we can get to that realm of glory, because it depends on God himself to work that through us and to abide in him so we can see the fulfillment of his plan. So he told them in advance what the solution to the problem will be. So he not only preempt them of the problem that will be coming, but remind them of the condition, remind them of the detriment of falling into that plan or into that predicament. But he said, listen, but all right, okay, I tell you about the, it's just like, you know, you knew that you have traversed the road many times, so you know where the pothole is and you know where the danger is, and you said to someone, listen, those are the danger zones, so keep away from it. Because you know where they are. But you continue, or you went on to remind them, but if you fall in, this is how you get out. So you not only provided them a way out, you remind them of the problem, preempt them of the problem, but you also giving them a solution that in case you still hard-headedly or inadvertently or forgetfully went in or fall into the traps, you don't have to stay there. Because God has the solution. He has provided an answer. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. See, so in 2 Chronicles chapter 12 and verse 14, the very next generation began to turn away from God and paid the high price. We see King Rehoboam did evil because he didn't seek the Lord. So in chapter 20, the country was split between Judah and Israel, and they were plagued with many problems. The situation concerning Judah has a great message for us. Verse 1 to 2, Judah was faced with an enemy that they could not handle. Glory to God, when you are faced with problems that is insurmountable, there's no progress towards a solution until the problem is acknowledged. So King Jehoshaphat was wise and sought help from God, the only one who not only had the answer, but can deal with the problem. I learned this long time ago. And I've practiced. I only learned, but I've practiced. I don't tell people my problem. I don't tell people my problem. For one, I mean, if you can help. You see, the bottom line is, No. I'm not saying you need to share stuff so people will understand where you're at so they can help pray for you. But there's a fine line between that and complaining and all these other stuff. So because this is it. You see, there are many folks that can help. But those can help don't have time to listen to you. They don't have time to listen to you griping and complaining. They don't. And those that cannot help have all the time in the world. See, you see the dilemma. You see the situation. So you're only wasting your time in trying to tell somebody who can help because they don't have time for you. And you're only wasting your time in relating to somebody that can't help you one bit. Maybe in a worse scenario than you are. But a
I'm here to tell you this morning about one that not only have all the time in the world, but the only one that has the answer to all your problems. So you have time? Oh yeah. Oh yeah, he can listen. You have all the time in the world to listen. Okay, he sits outside of time. Glory God. So if you think you can wear him with your, no, you can't. Glory. And not only does he have all the time to listen, but he can help. So quit running to the politician and your boss and your confidant and your so-called frenemy who take your stuff and gone over all over the place with it and all those kind of stuff. Yeah, try talking to God first. No, try talking to God first. You see, the thing is, if you talk to him first, then he's gonna direct you to the right person that he has already prepared. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. So here it is. Judah was faced with a problem. They were faced with an enemy that they could not handle. So King Jehoshaphat was wise, as I said, and sought the help from God, the only one who not only has the answer, but to deal with that problem. The problem in the world has been exasperated by what is happening. Have you read, you just heard in the Middle East. The last time Israel was attacked by Iran was 1985. I mean, they have done so by proxy, but it's been since 85 that they directly attack Israel herself. And to compound that, we have the situation that is going on between Ukraine and Russia. That just added to the whole problem of what we are facing in the world today. The moral decay that is going around us. The mayhem and hatred. It's more than we can handle alone. You see, we need to understand that we are facing an enemy that can overwhelm us if we try to stand up to him by ourselves. Because he can overwhelm us with us, because you see, he has been around longer than all of us. And he knows, and you see, and this is what he does. He's not really cunning, you know, it's because we give him more credit than anything else. Because if he cannot get you, to do evil, to do the wrong thing, you see, he gets you to do the right thing from your flesh. And this is where the problem lies, because you see, nothing in this flesh cannot please God. So even the devil try to help you to recommend or cause you to do good from the flesh, it's still an offense to God, because the flesh cannot please him. So you do the all these stuff, and you broad your shoulder, and you seek affirmation from men because it's in the flesh. Yes, you're helping the brother, you're helping the sister, and so on. But the accolades belongs to God. So even though you're doing it and you do the one thing, you're doing it right, what you have just done is religiousize it. Anything from the flesh is just religion. Because Christians, as believers, we must learn to respond to God from the Spirit. We must learn to respond to life's problem from the place of the heart. You see, this is the only decision that you can make will please God, because the decision from the heart is a culmination of the spirit and your intellect coming together in agreeing with God that what God says is so. Therefore, that decision resonates from that. Holy Ghost. But there's a solution to every problem that humanity faces. There is a solution because God has provided the solution. So Judah remember the promises of 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, will forgive their sin, will heal their land. Have you ever noticed that every single time most ministries talked about prayer or anything to do with prayer, that's the first thing that they come up with? It's a common denominator between every believers, so to speak, and so and I'm thinking, but the fact is that they ignore the part that says, if my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves, they start out by seeking the face of God. So they call folks to let's come together and seek the Lord for a solution to this problem. And the first criteria is humility, humbling yourself under the mighty hand of God. You see, there's a comparable scripture in the New Testament that deals with that says the same thing to us, where we as believers, and it is in 1 John chapter 1 verse 9. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and righteous to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. When we pour out our heart in genuine confession and repentance, how does God respond to us? He says that we are completely forgiven, and remind us of how Jesus sacrificed on the cross. He paid the penalty for all our sins, all our transgression. We have been declared justified, no longer guilty in His eyes. The Lord understands your struggle. He knows where you are. He hears your prayer. He knows what you're facing. He sees what you're going through. But He says, if you humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, He understands your struggle. As human, He walked this earth, and He did so. God had to come down and take on human flesh, you know, because you see, when you read the New Testament, you got to understand that yes, He's a God, He created us, but He didn't know what it is to sin. There are certain things that God didn't know. That sounds kind of, you know, outrageous, yeah? But you see, the thing is, He didn't know sin. And that is the reason why when you read the New Testament, you see so many. If a man, you know, you sin, the penalty is cruel. But here it is. God wants to walk where you walk. He wants to experience what you experience, so He can identify with you as a human. Hence, He took on flesh, experienced all that we have gone through, will go through. And not only did He experience it, He suffered the penalty for you and I. He wants you to find victory, not continue to feel shame because of your sin. He's a merciful and loving God. So at the writer of Hebrews chapter 2 and verse 14, going down, he says, since therefore the children share in flesh and blood, he himself likewise partook of the same thing through death, that he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is the devil. He took on flesh and blood because he loves us so much that he wants to make sure that nothing is left out. Which is why he says if you repent and confess, you are absolutely forgiven. Holy one of his, glory be to the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. So the example was given in chapter 20 of Chronicles, 2 Chronicles, chapter 20, verse 6 to 14. And God responded with an answer in verse 15 to 17. He simply told the folks back then that if they would trust him enough to show it through the way they live, he would take care of them. And the same is true today because there's so many Christians. People can talk a good talk. And you have some orators that they can convince you with the eloquency of speech. Man, they can captivate you. But behind that is just empty rhetoric. There's nothing behind that. There are some of them that I call them intellectual fools because they are so intellectual because that means, you know, my friend Bishop Ken Hart sent me, when he was in England many, many years ago, he sent me a thing that he said that he saw in the Times, I think it's the Times of England, in the obituary pages. You see, and it was the death of common sense. and it is true, when you look around and you confront and you talk to some people, you realize common sense is really dead for true. Because you see, you wonder, how can you be so intellectual and there's no common sense to it? But then if something dead is just dead, I guess. But Jesus was saying, telling the folks that if you trust me, if you trust me enough, then you need to show it by the way you live. God is saying the same thing to us today. If we trust him, then our lives should reflect that. He will make up the difference. Glory to God, if we only trust him. Too often we our lives lack the credibility because we are depending on and we are thinking about the consequences. But the consequences belongs to him. The consequences will prevent you from walking into your purpose. The consequences will prevent you from fulfilling your dream. The consequences will prevent you from attaining that which God has prepositioned you for. And in case you're still wondering, in case you don't know, you're not just here for you. You're not just here because you're here, because you're here. No, you're here for someone else. You are the answers to somebody else's prayer. So let's get rid of this ridiculous thing that, I'm here, I'm my own big man, and I don't need nobody. I'm independent. There's no independent human. If you think you're independent of each other or humanity, then I've just given you a few years. Just think a few years. I just make one sickness hit you. Just one misfortune or unfortunate situation or whatever you want to call it. Then you'll realize that you depend on someone else. Or else you're dead. The only thing, yeah, you depend on somebody to bury you. He's saying to us today, we must trust him. And if we trust him, then our lives should reflect that. It is significant that the message come to a people who were called by his name. Understand? It is significant. You see, when believers live according to what they believe, the world will pay attention. The result will be based only on absolute faith in God. So the children of Israel march into battle with a confident spirit. All they need was faith in God and a song. Glory be to the name of Jesus. When your faith becomes your evidence, God will fight for you. This is still your only hope. This is still your only hope. There is no earthly power that can deliver us. Without God's help, we cannot win this battle. We are facing an overwhelming enemy who has a vast army marching against us. Our only hope for victory is a fresh outpouring of God's presence. I want you to notice when God began to move in chapter 2 of 2 Chronicles, chapter 20, verse 22, in verse 6 they prayed. In verse 4 to 15, God gave them instruction. In verse 20, they believe. And in verse 26 to 29, he delivered them. The result of following his guidance is still in the camp. The same thing can happen in our world today. The only way out of our problems, the only way to overcome the situation that you're in, the only way to walk in your purpose, to fulfill your destiny, is understanding that God has already provided the answer. It's not a complicated test, because it's in here. Everything is in here. Everything is in the bird, in his word. Everything is in there. Everything that you need is in there. So when life getting overwhelming, when the situation getting overbearing, you need to turn to the word of God. When your so-called friend glory be to Jesus, start to sing funeral song over your life, and you think that that's my friend you're talking about, I'm just gonna give up. There's no hope. It's even worse when it's your own family, someone that you look up to, someone that you thought would be there for you, will help you through, and all this kind of stuff. Understand that when you're unable to look out, when you're unable to look around, you can look back and see where God has brought you from. And in looking back, then it gives you everything that you need to look up from whence cometh your hope. Glory be to the name of Jesus. So when you look around and all you're seeing is destruction and all you're hearing is ridicule and all you're experiencing is oh, glory be to the name of. I know I'm speaking to someone this morning who you have been there, and as a matter of fact, I'm hearing my spirit that there's someone in here this morning that is going through that period even now. When your very friend, your close associate, those that you look on, that you lean on, are slowly pulling out even the rug from underneath you while they're affirming you with words. It's a real classical example of being stabbed in the back. Because you see, you turn your back on a friend because you know, you think your friend will protect your back. But your friend is the one who is destroying you, and you're thinking, what use is life then? It doesn't make any sense. The reality is, no, it doesn't make sense. And it doesn't have to make sense, because if you can make sense of it, then you can find a solution and you can think that, this is me. I've heard it many times over that God will not give you more than you can bear. But truly, if you are in Him and dependent on Him and walking with Him and allow Him to lead you, then He will not give you more than you can bear. But if you are one of the person that has this tendency to think that going to God as a last resort, then guess what? He's going to give you more than you can bear, because He wants you to know nothing in you can provide the answer to life's problem. No amount of counsel in your friends and so cannot add up. But He's saying to you, when life is giving you more than you can bear, when you're at your end of your rope, no, He didn't say to hang yourself. No, at the end of your rope, you look to Him. Because He just wants your attention. And when He gets your attention, you see, you should not or must not give the accolades to anyone, because He don't share His glory with anyone. It must belong to Him and Him alone. And He knows that the only way He can get the affirmation and get the everything that He Himself deserves, the only way He can get the glory from your lips is giving you more than you can bear. Okay, see, when you get more than you can bear, and He brought you out, you cannot tell nobody that it was Tom, Dick, or Harry. It was my nene, it was my godmother, my godfather, step up. No, it doesn't matter, no human being, it doesn't matter who it is. You are forced to declare that, only God. Because when you look around and you see where you have been and how you have been brought out, you cannot even explain how you have been brought out. It's because of Him. But so He's saying to us this morning, He's saying to you and I, He has really provided the answer. If you notice, it is, He has, the answer is already provided. What it means then, it doesn't matter the question. Glory be to God. It means then, it doesn't matter the question that you have. The answer is already provided. All you need to do now is ask the correct question. Glory be to the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. That's the kind of God we serve. He's always there for us, caring, compassionate. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And understand where he has brought you to. He's not about to leave you there. He didn't bring you this far to leave you. He didn't bring you this far to let you down. He that has begun a good work is able to take you to the end. All you have to do is trust him. God bless you.
Only trust him. Only trust him. Only trust him now. He will save you. He will save you. He will save you now. Only trust him. Only trust him. Only trust him. Only trust him now.
He will save you.
He will save you. He will save you. He will save you now.
Sing, only trust him.
Only trust him. Only trust him. Only trust him now.
He will save you.
He will save you. He will save you. He will save you now.
You have heard the word that the Lord has for us today. You're not here by mistake. You're not here by chance. This word is for you. It is for you.
He will save you. He will save you.
Sometimes we allow culture to limit how far we go in the Lord. We allow culture to limit us, our trust. We see it in the word, but we never believe it can happen to us. And what the Lord is saying to us, if we will only obey him, if we will only humble ourselves to him, if we will only put away our small, limited imagination of God and see him as the great and mighty God he is. So therefore we need a revelation of Jesus Christ. We need a revelation of who our God is. We need the revelation of why Jesus Christ died and why we are alive today. Because we could have gone like the millions that did not live to see today. Have we ever sit down and wonder, why am I alive? And the situation that you thought would have taken you out, the situation that you thought would have taken your life, the Lord step in and bring deliverance. Have you ever think, why am I here? Am I being effective? to the plan of God for my life and for those he has brought into my care and into my sphere of influence. Why am I even in this house today to hear this word? Is it that we need to hear it so we can go back and be effective to other people who might be in need and might be where we have been and don't know how to come out of their situation? We are not here, as Pastor said, because we are here. There's a purpose and a reason. I'm here to bring deliverance to God's people. I'm here to bring salvation. I am a witness of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. I think it was John that says, I am an eyewitness. I have been with Jesus. I have walked with him. I have talked with him. We have communicated together. We have grown together. I am an eyewitness that he is indeed God. I was there when he stepped out on water. And I was the one that he called me and says, come. If you desire to walk on water, if Jesus, if that's you, then bid me come. And he said, come. I was the one that walked. I am an eyewitness of the saving grace of Jesus. I am an eyewitness of the healing power and the miracles. I am an eyewitness. Oh, Jesus. I wish somebody would understand that you're not here because you're here. As we heard of the rumors of war, and these are end time signs. Believers, get right in the spirit. Be watchful. Get up and do what God has called you to do and what he saved you to do. He didn't just save you to go to heaven. He saved you because there are other people who need to know the way to salvation. Who need to know I can trust him. Who need to know I can depend on him for this. That's why we are here. We are his eyewitness. And so the word of the Lord says, if you hear his voice today, harden not your heart. But surrender to him. I will arise and go to my father. And I will do what my father said to do. Some of us are backslidden in our mind. Some of us have gone cold and indifferent. And you hear the gospel and some of us are our heart. Yes, a Christian, but our heart is hardened. And the Spirit of the Lord is speaking to us this morning. Change. Repent. Repentance means to turn. You're on this path. Turn and go the other part. Go where God leading you. Go where God. Don't look at the difficulties, because he's able. He wants to bring you to a platform where people know the difficulty you have been through, but no smell like it or look like where you're coming from. He wants to make you into a testimony for his glory. Can you stand with me? Trust in the Lord.
Trust in the Lord.
You're here this morning and you have gone weary in your faith. You have gone weary in trusting God. You even say you can't pray no more because you pray and pray and pray, but nothing is happening. The devil is a liar. God says, if you seek after me, I will be found. When you seek for me with your whole heart, I will allow you to find me. He will not go back on his word. When the seed is sown, there's no problem in the seed. In other words, there's no problem in the word when it is sown. The problem is with the recipient, what type of soil you have, what type of soil the seed is being sown into. Is it a hardened ground? And if it is, he's saying to us, break up your fallow ground. Turn and change. The altar is open. And if you find yourself being short of what God wants you to do, if you are not, if you're here in this house and you're not saved, you don't know what the next move is. You don't know what if God don't allow you to see tomorrow. But the word of the Lord says, as long as here we are here, it is the acceptable time. It is the day of salvation. You're here and you don't know Jesus. You're here and you have been backslidden. I am encouraging you to come back to Jesus. He has gone through too much for you to end up in hell. He has put the word of God in every area that you come to your ears. You can never say, I did not know. The word of the Lord says, Paul in his writing said, you are inexcusable, O man, whoever you are. You are inexcusable because God sent his word. And I'm asking, I'm begging, and I'm pleading with you. If you do not know Jesus, it's good time to accept him. If you have been backslidden in your mind, though you come to church same way. Yes, backsliders come to church every day. But they are not in right standing with the Lord. I am calling you back to trust him again. I promise you, when you pray in sincerity, because you can't pray with all kind of hypocrisy in your heart and then you expect God to hear. No, it don't work like that. He said, if you will humble yourself and turn, in other words, repent, then I, God, will hear and I will heal your land. I will heal your brokenness. Is there anybody in this house want to commit their life to Jesus? Want to recommit your life to the Lord? Says God, I'll go where you want me to go. I know, understand that I'm not here by chance, and I'm not alive by chance, or alive because I'm better than anybody else, or I'm better than those who have gone on from the land of the living. But to their grave, I'm not better. It's just that your mercy, God, is upon me. You have mercy, and you have given me another chance to repent. Hallelujah. If you have a situation and you want us to believe God with you, the altar is open.
With all of thine heart,
if you have gone cold, oh God, if you have gone cold, he said, come back, my child. I want to put you on fire again. The worst situation, however, to be in is being a lukewarm Christian. You're neither a Christian, or you don't know where you want. You're not backslider, and you're not on fire for God. Lukewarm. But he wants to change that in your life today. As I plead with you, you can lift your hands if you need prayer. Where you are. Lift your hands if you need prayer. Where you are. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. If you are lifting your hand, lift it above your head so I can see. And have somebody come and pray with you. Hallelujah. Brother Gibbs, can you go to that sister right behind you? And just press your hand upon her.
And good understanding.
Anybody else?
Trust him. Trust him.
The and he shall direct. You have a faith issue,
shall direct.
Trust him.
Thy path.
If you have a believing issue, that it can happen to anybody else, but it can't happen to me. No. Our God is not a liar, and he will never lie. If you say he will do this, if you do that, then you have to come in agreement and understand that you have to play your part, and he will bring it to pass in your life. Hallelujah. Father, I give you praise today. I thank you for your word. I thank you, Lord God, that you will never leave, never send your word and leave it without a weakness. Oh God, we are eyewitness of your miracles. We are eyewitness, Lord God, of your healing and deliverance. Oh God, some of us, you allow us to go to rock bottom so that you can lift us up. And when you lift us up, the eyes of everyone who know our condition wonder, how is it possible? Because that is the God you are. And so we want to say thank you, Lord God. Thank you for your servant that brought forth the word, even though he's not feeling well, Lord God. You have allowed him to bring forth the word with power. God, I pray that you will let your living water flow over his soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and make him whole. Wipe away all doubt and fear and take all pride. Bring him to your love, God. Bring him by your side, Jesus. It's in your name we stand today. It's in your name, Lord God, we adore. It's in your name, Lord God, that we worship. We worship you forever. You're an amazing God. And so this amazing word that you have sent this morning, and a word of comfort that you have sent to your people, may we never soon forget it. But Lord God, let it live on in us and encourage us as we walk this pilgrim pathway. For there is coming a day when your word says there will be famine, not for food, but for the very word. Oh God, help us in these last days, oh God, to be sensitive to the season and the time that we are living in, and to make our calling and election sure. We thank you. We thank you for worship, Lord, for people, Lord God, as we gather here, we worship you. We thank you more than anything else for your presence. We thank you, God. And I pray, Father God, that your people will be blessed throughout this week as we go from this house, Lord, that your continuous blessing will be upon our lives as we trust you in every detail, the big things and the small things. Cause us to trust you, only trust you, always. Cause our faith, oh God, to grow. Give us the gift of faith, oh God, for your word says we should covet spiritual gift. So we ask today, Lord, that you will give us the gift of faith. The gift, Lord God, to see miracles, signs, and wonders that you said would follow us in this season. Give us the gift, Lord God, of love, that we would love each other unconditionally. Because your word declared that love covers a multitude of sin. God, so give us a love for each other. Give us a love, Lord God, whether we are of this congregation or any congregation, as long as they are called saints. Oh God, help us to love each other and care about each other. Give us a love for sinners, oh God, that they would come to know you. Give us the gift of love. For your word, Lord Jesus, said you love the world, oh God, that you send your only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in you should not perish, but have everlasting life. Give us that love, Lord God, that you came when you came, Lord Jesus. you die, you will have unconditional love. And though we fall, we are fallen, yet, Lord God, your hand is outstretched to pick us up. Give us that love for each other, God. Help us not to judge each other, but to love each other unconditionally. To you be glory. To you be glory. To you be all the praise. To you be all the honor, God, as we, oh God, accept your love today. As we accept your unconditional love. I love that knowing that other people hate you, but love them just the same. God, give us that gift of love. Do good to those who despitefully use us and persecute us and say all manner of evil against us. Give us that love, oh God, to love them in spite of. I give all praise and all honor to you. I ask that you will dismiss us today with your richest blessing, oh God. And as we would come again, Lord, we give you thanks always. In our homes, on our job, in the city, in the field, we thank you for multitude blessings. In Jesus' mighty name. Just want to say thank you for everyone that came into this house this morning. Thank you for worshiping with us, book club, and every member. Thank you, Deliverance Worship Center people and visitors. I just want to say thank you for coming and allow us in our worship to ushering the Spirit of the Lord. As you go forward today, may you practice the presence of the Lord. And you can only do that when you worship Him in, when you feel like it and you don't feel like it, you give Him praise. You, what you are doing, you are practicing the present. For the angel of the Lord encamp round about those who fear Him. And because you fear Him with reverence and you love Him, you will always in communication with Him. And even the part that you will be disappointed, because we will get disappointed, but we are able to say thank you, Lord, because you're working it together for my good. When you do that, you're saying, God, I welcome you in my space. You live in me. And so I pray today throughout this week, if you have never done that, start with the little thing. Just, God, I give you thanks. I can walk. I can see. I thank you. There are others who can't do just the little things, because they are so important. Granted, honor Him, praise Him, and watch your life move you from one dimension to the next dimension only because you cultivate the presence. You practice the presence. Practice, communicate. Don't just want to talk to God when you go on your knee. No, talk to Him all the time. So when you go on your knee, you went with confidence because you know His angel gonna stand up right there listening to you, because He come at your word, as He said to Daniel. I come at your word. It is God's angel, and He placed them to minister to every single one of us. Check out Hebrew. He said they are ministering spirits sent for to minister to those who are the heir of salvation. Don't run away your angel because you complain and you fail to give God praise. But every time you open your mouth and praise God, you watch the angel of God come. He loves it when you praise Him, God. He loves it. So again, I thank you all for coming into this place. Lift your hands for the blessing. Now may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, thank you, Jesus. Ah, my soul died. The love of God the Father, the full fellowship and the communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, remain, and abide with us all, both now and forever. And everyone say, amen. May God bless you. Have a great afternoon.